Ron Clements was born on April 25, 1953 in Iowa. At just 2 years old, his love for animation began to blossom with the drawing of his two favorite TV characters, Woody Woodpecker and Mighty Mouse. Woody Woodpecker would show behind-the-scenes footage, which was fascinating to Clements' toddler brain. But it wasn't until around the age of 9 when he developed a greater interest in animation that was sparked by the film Pinocchio.
Yeah, two big monsters with big green eyes.
Monsters? Weren't you...
After seeing this film, he ventured to the library in attempts to seek information on animation, where he found a book on the development of Disney. After this, he spent a lot of his time at a theater in his hometown watching animated films. He also began making comic books, drawing more frequently, and writing scripts. Later on in his teen years, Ron began making his own animated films. His first film that he developed using a Super 8 camera was about 15 minutes long and was called The Shade of Sherlock Holmes. He also had a part-time job at the local COX City television station, and one of his short films was aired. A broadcast executive from Los Angeles saw the film and contacted Clements, informing him that he could provide contact with Hanna-Barbera, a producer of Saturday morning cartoons. His interview with Hanna landed him the job, and he ended up moving to California right out of high school. Here, he got accepted into Disney's talent development program. During this time, Clements also began a 2-year apprenticeship with Frank Thomas, who was a supervising animator for Disney. He began as an animator for The Rescuers and Pete's Dragon in 1977, and then became an executive animator for The Fox and the Hound and The Black Cauldron. The next film he worked on was The Great Mouse Detective, although this time he wasn't the animator, but the director. He based his film off of his own original first animated short, The Shades of Sherlock Holmes, and worked on it for nearly 2 years before it was completely finished. Clements' next film idea would not only save the studio's decreasing numbers, but kick off the Disney Renaissance. This animated film is the no other The Little Mermaid. The idea for this particular film was brought about when Ron was at a bookstore and came across the written story of The Little Mermaid. He wanted to keep the essence of the film, while also making it more kid-friendly, as the ending was rather grotesque for a children's audience. He proposed his idea to his coworkers and was originally denied, with people saying it was a girls' movie, but that perspective didn't last very long. This is where Clement's style of directing begins to become clear. The protagonist is not only a female, but is also bold, independent, and brave. This is seen from the very beginning of the film, when Ariel gets in conflict with her father over missing the recital and going to the circus. She shows a sense of courageousness in being able to stand up to him. Ariel's bravery doesn't stop there, though. Throughout the film, the audience can see many instances where Ariel has no fear in expressing the ways that her opinions differentiate from her father's. Another way that Ariel shows bravery is her curiosity-driven attitude. Her curiosity about humans encourages nearly everything that she does, and she refuses to allow fear to get in the way of her discovering answers. This is seen when she's exploring the Christian flounder and nearly gets eaten by a shark. When her father commands her not to go to the surface because humans are dangerous, but she does anyway. And when she makes a deal with the sea witch Ursula that could cost her her soul. Ariel is not any ordinary princess, but one who takes risks in order to get what she wants. After The Little Mermaid's immense success, Disney began making more animated films again. Clements continued directing films such as Aladdin in 1992, Hercules in 1997, Princess and the Frog in 2010, and then Moana in 2016. Clements' next film, The Princess and the Frog, is one for the books. It was nominated for an Academy Award and won several Annies. Once again, Clements pursues the theme of female leads in The Princess and the Frog. Tiana, like Ariel and The Little Mermaid, is a strong, hardworking, and independent woman. She has been dreaming about opening up her own restaurant since she was a young girl, and her dream becomes her reality. This was due to working extremely hard to achieve her goals, despite the many obstacles that she faces throughout the film. Such as financial instability and turning into a frog. Tiana's determination to reach her goal is seen pretty early on in the film, when she is shown working really hard at work, coming home exhausted, and then going right back to work. Tiana breaks the stereotype of needing a man to save her or provide for her, because she clearly shows throughout the movie, with her witty and sarcastic remarks, that she can take care of herself.
Good night, Cass. Good morning, Jinx.
Not only is Tiana breaking the gendered stereotypes, but she is also changing history by being the first black princess ever to be seen in Walt Disney Animation. Clements continues on with the strong female role in his next film, Moana. Moana goes on a journey to save her island by restoring the heart of Te Fiti. Moana's father does not approve of her going beyond the reef, but despite his input, she decides to do it anyway. Any of this sound familiar? The Little Mermaid, perhaps? Moana pairs up with the demigod Maui, who is self-absorbed to say the least. After they team up, Maui shares that he needs his hook in order to have powers, so they set out on an adventure to Lalate in an island inhabited by monsters to retrieve his hook. There! Along the way, the two approach the Kakamora, which are murderous little pirates who want to steal the heart of Te Fiti. Moana doesn't shy away from danger, but instead faces it head on. When they finally arrive at the monstrous island, Maui underestimates Moana's bravery despite her proving herself against the Kakamora. He makes the assumption that she would rather wait at the top than jump into the realm of monsters with him, but Maui was proven wrong.
Dum-dum, she's not even here. No mortal's gonna jump into the realm of...
Even as they were at risk of getting killed by a 50-foot crab, Moana acted as bait to help her newfound friend get his possession back.
Wait a minute. Oh, it's a human.
Later on in the film, Moana and Maui face a murderous lava monster, which breaks Maui's hook and causes him to abandon her. But despite this, Moana's courage shines through as she goes back to Te Fiti on her own in order to save her island and her people. Due to her immense bravery that she continuously shows throughout the film, she has been described as a heroine rather than a princess. Clements clearly has a knack for making films with strong female characters, starting with The Little Mermaid and progressing all the way to Moana. It is seen that as he continues to make animated films, the protagonist gradually becomes more independent and breaks more and more stereotypes. Clements communicates to his viewers that a woman can accomplish anything and everything that she sets her mind to, and he's right.
Damn.